Hi, I think Swedish genealogy is rather good because it's rather straightforward. So what you have is that you have the best tool, I think, is this Archive Digital. So here you have, for example, a household page. So that is AI 19 from 1875 to 1884. It's image 23 and page 252. 252 is the page in the physical book. So here you have when people, the priest visit the families, and then here that you see they visit every year. And if you are moving in or moving out from a parish, you are registered in another book, but you can also say moved in. So here we moved in from the old book, page 290. And then here, this is a good priest. Next book is 387. So now we're in Säffnäs. It's part called Dalarna, or in the old days they were called Kopparbergs län, county, and W was for Kopparberg. Tyfors, I think, is some blacksmith place, and we have a special blacksmith register, so maybe we can look in that. I have lost my CD, so I don't know where it is right now. But what we also had, but I was too lazy, was that we had... this is maybe Mats, M-A-T-T-S. He's number 16. I can't read this. So this is the birth record from 1768. What we had was that we had his death record. I can show you how it works. So this is also a tree I found when I did the search. It seems to be the correct person, and they have done rather good genealogy. Mensch the source. But here we have him, and you also have from Tyfors, where you have most of the people, you have a book that can be ordered. And most people use that as a... reference book. Never seen it. But we have Karl-Erik Wetterskog here. And the cool thing about him is born 1735. And we have in the death register here. So the death register is here. You have the Swedish citation. So this is the county. Then you have a county letter. The parish is this. County. F is a letter telling what kind of book it is. So this is a death record, then it's F. And then we have when it was, image, when it was scanned by Orca Digital, page is the physical page in the book, and this is the unique ID. And so then if we go up here, then I just take this ID and jump. Then we get, I ask someone else to translate it, I'm too tired. But we have Karl Ersson Wetterskog, född i Örebro, born in Örebro, 1735. Father was hövitsman, I think. That's, I'm not sure. Erik Ersson. So it's Erik and the son of Erik. So his father was Erik. And then you have some Tilström, which I don't understand. Mother was Stina Adams daughter. So her father was Adam. I can't read it. 12 something. I think this is the church book, Katchesen, Spörsmål. So if he was a good person or not, but I'm not sure at all. But I asked in G2D if someone can do or more skilled than me. And then we have Vetter something. Kajsa Olsdotter. F- 4 children, 2 daughters, 2 sons, something, something, and so on. What I thought we could do is, which I think is rather fun, if we look at Carl, he died in, take Mats instead. He died in Tyfos 1852. It's easy to read them. And then if we look for, Tyfos is in Paris, Sefsnes. And then what we do a search on Sefsnes, and then we get it. It's in W. W stands for Kopparberg, but it's now called Dalarna. So then we have the Hasel books. We have Congregation, which is later, in the early 1900, moving in, moving out to a parish. You have birth records, you have ban and marriage, and you have the death records, and you have military records, and you have estate and inventories. So I thought we could check if they have done a good work with the estate and inventory. And normally, 3 months after they died, you do an estate and inventory. And if we are lucky, it's a register, but it's not a register here. But we can start, check. So 1852 September. So then we think it's late in the book of 1852. And in the estate and inventory, you say normally how many children you have, if they survived, and then you start telling everything. If you have a spoon, 5 spoons, 5 glasses, 1 cow, and so on. So that's one of the best documents to find. So I think it's in the end of this book. As you don't do it the first day someone dies. And the reason you have to do it is some tax stuff. Uh-oh. So here we can see. Year 1844, this is chaos. If it's a good parish, they are in order. Year 1852, here we have, 19 April. We will have something after April. Looks like they are November, here we have. And this is done after the widow Stina Ersdotter Jonsdotter. And this is the bad thing. So if you're lucky, you find a register, but here we don't have it. And here we have Hemmasaga Nils. Hemmasaga means that you're Onster. And here we have a female, so that's not the correct person. Here we have Sjöard, Carl Sjöard. Jons Nilsson. Enkan Maria Persdotter, Mats Wetterskog. And if they don't own anything, then you don't do this. Hustru, so it's female. Here we have Kolaren. Here you have Nils Nilsson. Lisa Nilsdotter. Oops, Ersson. That's Jonas Ersson. It looks like it's chaos here. We are in book for 8. No, it's, yeah, but it's early 52. Here's the early 52, so it could also be in the next book then. Too early. 51. 52 April, it's too early. January, it's too early. We check in the next book. Just. If we are lucky. Sometimes they have a register in the beginning, and they, normally they can also have more documents. 52 April. It's too early also in the next book. 52 April. Or too early. India. Lars. Wrong name. It takes too much time. Carl. Last one now. Elizabeth. Oh. Yeah, but I can show you what we found out. And my understanding is that you are related to Anne-Louise, and what we find is that she is if you can find her. Here we have, I guess, Isaac Westerskog, and here you can see he was a master, which is good work, and then he was is a day laborer, so then it means he doesn't have a daily work, so he has to walk around to get something, which is a, I think, big step in the wrong direction. And here you have his wife, born 32 in Ljusnans by, and then all the children are born in Säffnäs, which is in Dalarna. And it looks like they have an active genealogy society also. And Anne-Louise is the person you are interested in. What we can see here also is that North America is mentioned for Carl Simon. 63 he was born, and then he's moving 79. So we asked when he's 16 years old, which is feel a little bit young. What we can see is that Anne-Louise, she is born 69, and she is starting to, when she's 50, to work. So I can't think that the father has, the economy is less good. So on. Maybe what we should do is try to find his next book, 85. Next book, 387. See if we can find it. Säffnäs. A19. So here it's for 75. Then we guess it's here. Did it say 319? No, it was not. 387. That's, if we are lucky, they have a good numbering scheme. 387. Yes, they have. 387. So here we have the next book. Dag Carl is up here. They are still in T-Force. And here we have Jan Isak. And now just three children is living at home. And we can see that North America is number 19. Karina Amanda is traveling to America. Next book, can't read. Stockholm. Next book. So I do like that. And then we add this information to Jan. And I add it in the beginning as a statement for proving that he is born. What I do is that I take the whole this stuff, and then I use this unique ID as a ref name, so I can reuse it. Maybe it's make it tough, difficult to understand, but I like it. And now we can see it should be in next book 381, and then we are 381. And hopefully it's 381. No, it's not my day. 381. So this is how you do genealogy in Sweden, rather boring. But you get sometimes tougher. Here we have that he died, I think, because he's overstricken. And here he also dagkar, and then his fabriks, he's working in the factory. Inflyttad, and he died, yes, 07. So what we can say now is that we have his death date, 1907. And it's March 19, and that is in this book. Then the question, did I? No, I haven't added it. I do the same. So then we have proof for this, and then I do a copy for the holes. Sorry if my mistake. Source. Identification. And as he is dead, and they are also saying fattig, so they are poor. In the household book, the family is now mentioned fattig. What I do is that I add categories, and then we could read more about fattig. You have utfattig, which is even more poor, and if you do like this, I hope we get something that is clickable. We will see. It's now mentioned as fattig. No. I will see what we have. It's my misspelled, I think. Fattig I have, yes. And then you have fattig, jon, utfattig. Ah, cool. So this is the correct spelling. So what I have done for Sweden now is categories. And then you have a top category, old the Farmers Society with some good links, and then you have words you find, for example, like mästare. Mästersmed. So this is what they were. It's a fully taught smith. So this is in Swedish, but I guess you can do Google Translate on it, so. Or if you would like to translate it, it's good for other people. So this is what they have. They had a diploma saying that they are approved. Category. This is my stupid thing. Category. Then we have category fattig. And what we should do now is that we should check in the death book. So we have 1907, March 19. And then we look for Säfnäs, 1907. Birth, death. And then we go to 1907. Looks like it could be in the end. 1911 we have up here. So in the death book, in the old books, they can have a long story, but here you have, if you're lucky, death reason. 1906, 1907, March 90. Så dagkaren Jan Isak Wetterskog Tyfors. Born 3259, page 381, March 29. So it's nothing interesting here. No death reason. So here you have lunginflammation. That's another reason. So I just add, we normally I take the death read. I take death records first. So now we have the date, we have a death record. See if Cepheus the later is indexed. Statement inventory. Is this the same I looked at last time? Innos technique. So you have for the court books. Maybe 1907 is your typewriter. March. No. January. March. '06, '07. Looks like it. Oh, here we have it. This is much better. So then we have, see, 1902. Now it's '97, February. June 1904, 1906. Seems to be a little bit of chaos here. 1906. But as it says, they are poor. Maybe we don't get something. Widow. Nils Gustav Elg. Beda. The Wife. Ann-Louise Persdotter. Kolare. He was working in a factory, we learned. Hemmasägare, then you're owning your house, and maybe you have also a little bit of land. Worker. Farmaid. I think this that it says they are poor is not a good indication that you will have a state and inventory. Lord Carr, that's the same as he was. Johanna Karlsson. Anna Persson. Lunds Jönsson. Widow. Widow. Anders Olsson, wrong name. Henrik Israelsson, no. What's his name now? Jan Isak. Nils Alfred. So this is one of the best documents to find. Because you can, if you have more debts in the family, you can see how much they are owning. So you have the debts, you have the assets, you have many shoes they had and so on. And in Sweden it was really poor. In the 1860s, we had the last big starvation. I give up. It's later, it's 2 in the night. Give it to me. You can see it's just 2 pages, so the whole this area seems not to be too wealthy. You can have 1 page, you can have 30 pages, I've seen. Wet. John Isaac, here it is. John Isaac. So then what I do is that I take this one, poof, and then we go over here. And what we have is that we have a date. Like, 07, May 4, estate and inventory. That was cool. So I can try to read it for you. Why am I doing everything so complicated? 1907, the 4th May. So if this is correct done, then they sort of tell that the daughter is in North America, if they know it. But I guess they know it. Of the dog Karen, daily laborer, John Isaac Wetterskog in Tyfors, who died the 19th last March, and who... after him alive is the widow Maria Charlotta Wetterskog, born Jansson, myndig, means that you are over 18 or 20 years. Dottern Emma Charlotta, born 27 July 1856 and married with August Jansson, Stockholm. Myndige sonen, also over 18 or 20, Johan Isaac, born 4th October 1857 and living in North America. So here you have another one, Johan Isaac. Myndige dottern, Johanna Matilda, born 12 December 1861, married with August Örn from Forsbacka, that's in the northern Sweden. Myndige dottern, Anna Louisa, born 25 August 1869, married with Knut Hansson, in norra Amerika. Myndige dottern Hedda Augusta, born 21st of January 1872, Amanda Katarina 26 januari, son Gustav Adolf 23rd September 1876, maybe they are living at home. Boet uppgavs, the bo was registered by the widow and the son Gustav Adolf, who have the following things. So in ny silver, it's some silver things. You have a watch, old one, a copper, coffee to make coffee with, messing, I don't know in English, it's candlelights and for cooking food. So they have 10 kroner, that's $1, and you can never imagine what they had. And then we have on page 2 a scissor, 50, a knife, 2 axes, 2 saws, a bed, 1 bed, 1 sofa, 2 tables, what called? Wheelchair, no, what to say? Spinning wheel, no, 3 chairs. One watch for the wall, 1 mirror. Can't read. mattresses, sheets for the bed, and clothes. Books worth two. One cow, so that's good. So that's not, they were not so poor. What that it said is they were poor. I think a cow, then you need to be, maybe a lot of debts, that could be. So here it's for things doing mattor. And then we have the depths thing. Cost for funeral 20 and then bootsmaller. Then we have it's signed and G.A. Betterskog Maria Charlotta Wetzko. And the question is, looks like she has written this herself. What you can see, if it's the same style or not, and normally you have a cross mark or something like that if you can't write. And then you have Gustav, Ander and Jonas. So here you have some signatures, which is rather cool. But I upload this. So then we have the estate and inventory. So the interesting thing was would be to have it after also Maria Charlotta, to see if she, what kind of life she has had. Hope it make fun.